one of the major chapter, amalgamation, absorption and reconstruction. It is there in group 1 and group 2. Group 1, 16 marks group 2, and sometimes another 4 marks can come for a question, and that way it can be even for 36 marks it comes in the IPCC examination. So in one chapter it is definite question. Without this question there is no question paper. So like that is the importance of this chapter, amalgamation, absorption and reconstruction. Please settle down. So having understood the significance of the topic from an examination perspective, then let us move into the topic. Let us learn initially what is amalgamation, what is absorption, what is reconstruction. Two existing companies, say A Limited, B Limited, two companies, wow. A Limited and B Limited. Apple Limited. Apple. Sir, what is that? I don't know. What is the relevance? Oh, okay, okay. Friends, please, I don't know what you have planned today. Now please listen. Please stop talking. Friends, please. We are under one of the major chapter. Amalgamation, absorption and reconstruction. So we have got two companies, A Limited and B Limited. Both these companies goes into liquidation and a new company is formed, C Limited. It is called amalgamation. Two existing companies losing their identities, a new company is getting formed, we call it as amalgamation. In an absorption, two existing companies, both were existing companies. In that, one company goes into liquidation. After that event of rearrangement, still A Limited will continue to have its old identity. A Limited is actually acquiring B Limited. Then this is called absorption. A Limited absorbs B Limited. Here it is. Two companies were amalgamated into forming a new company, C Limited. So this is the basic difference between amalgamation and absorption. Please respond. In the event of a reconstruction, so we have, this is amalgamation, we have absorption, then we have something called reconstruction. Totally different from all these concepts, but still we can explain with the same only. A Limited is an existing company. A Limited is an goes into liquidation. A new company is formed, B Limited, takes over A Limited, is called reconstruction. So then you find absorption and reconstruction happening to be same. But the issue is that in an absorption there were two existing companies. In that one existing company gets liquidated. Liquidated means it is wind up, it is closed. And another existing company takes this liquidated company and will have the original identity. Then it is called absorption. In a reconstruction you see, there is only one existing company. respond. That company goes into the owners of that company only will float here, and that company will take over the liquidated company. Are you following also thereby? This is called a reconcile. It is something like a change of name only. The owners of this A Limited only will be the owners of B Limited. Just a change of name. But here there is real change in ownership happening. Correct, Appa? The owners of A Limited is acquiring the business of B Limited. Here the same owners of A Limited floats in new company called and the B Limited acquires A Limited. So what is the need, purpose, all these things discussion later. So we understood about there are three concepts involved here: amalgamation, absorption, reconcile. Are they same or different? They are different. So conceptually they are different. They find, I mean, in amalgamation there will be two existing companies. Both the companies goes into liquidation. And we find in case of absorption, we find there is only one company goes into liquidation. There will be two existing company. One company goes into liquidation. Another existing company takes over the company going into liquidation. This is called absorption. So in case of amalgamation, you see that there is a new company is formed. In case of absorption, you don't see any new company. But in case of reconstruction, a new company is formed. Are you following this? Please respond.
Yes, sir.
So we used to explain with an example relating to the day-to-day household activity. So don't make noise and all. Just take it as example. If you like it, okay. Otherwise, leave it. Now listen. Listen. In this, very good, milk, sugar, tikashan, spelling theriyadunala, black tea. Now please listen. Listen. So I will ask some tough questions you should answer.
Yes,
what is the color of milk?
White.
What is the color of the sugar?
White.
What's the similarity you find? Yes. Sir, please don't make noise. Friends, please don't make noise. Don't disturb. What is the state of the milk?
Liquid.
Sugar? Now listen, we take sugar and put into
milk.
Now sugar, still it will retain the solid state?
No.
It will lose the state?
Yes, sir.
Whether the milk retains the original state?
Yes.
Absorption. Milk absorbed sugar.
Wow.
So we find two existing items in that. After they combine, there is only one old existing item still retaining the original identity. Respond.
Yes, sir.
Now what is the color of the milk mixed with sugar?
White.
What is the color of this black tea?
Black.
Please listen. Take this decoction. Pour into the milk. You will get a wonderful tea. Understood? Now what is the color of that tea? It is not black, not white. Both the components lost the identity. A new identity is born. So in the event of amalgamation, whatever companies combining into that, all will lose their identity, is what we call it as. But in absorption, at least one company will retain the original identity, is what we call it as. absorption. This is the basic difference between amalgamation and absorption. Through this we have learned amalgamation, absorption, as well as how to make a good tea. Understood? It will be very helpful for you all in future. For you all only. Because don't be over dependent out of experience. Now please settle down. Reconstruction. Reconstruction, nothing we can tell. Keep that milk for some number of days, it will become curd. Reconstruction. Okay. So there is only one item, that loose identity, a new identity is coming. Yesterday, full day tax class actually changed your mood like anything. Friends, please allow me to take class. At least that, I mean that also you're not allowing. Please listen. Friends, please. So we are taking in a very, very important chapter, amalgamation, absorption and reconstruction. In group 1 and group 2, it will come for 16 and 16, around 32 marks. Confirmed 32 marks, friends. So please put all your efforts in learning this topic. Firstly, we were learning the difference between amalgamation, absorption and now initially I told you the difference between all these three. Even though all these three are different, now we are going to make them same. For accounting purpose, we don't have any difference between amalgamation, absorption, reconstruction. So when we have the title 3, it is not that we have three different problem areas. All are in a single problem area. It is a single chapter. Understood? So, in this activities or event of amalgamation, absorption or reconstruction, we classify the companies involved in the amalgamation or absorption or reconstruction into two companies. One is selling company. Or usually we call it as vendor company. In the wordings of accounting standard, it is called transferor company. Other company will be called as purchasing company. Or transferee company. So we have, as per AS 14, now the entire topic, now let me introduce that also, will be discussed as per AS 14, accounting for amalgamation. But this AS 14 has got a very limited application. The topic is very wide, so that way whatever we learn is not fully as per AS. We learn full AS 14, but AS 14 doesn't cover the full aspect of amalgamation observed, which means there are some other generally accepted accounting conventions, principles also followed in completing the topic amalgamation, absorption and reconstruction. So we classify the companies into two, which is selling company and purchasing company. Normal, simple layman's understanding or for accounts and all, we will discuss throughout our class the companies into two, selling company and purchasing company. Understood? Now in the wordings of accounting standard, whenever you use some text, it is always called as transferor company and transferee company. Transferor company is selling company. Transferee company is purchasing company. Like that, we will have two types of companies. Understood? Please respond. Now, whether it is amalgamation A, B, C, in this, A and B will be regarded as selling companies and C will be purchasing company. That's all. Only two categories of companies. You have A and B alone, in that B is the selling company, A is the, here A, B. A is the selling company, B is the purchasing company. So which means, even if I have A, B, C, D, E, in that A, B, C, D liquidated, respond. E takes over all this company. It is what? First, is it what? Amalgamation, absorption. It is absorption. Respond. If E is also liquidated and F is formed, means amalgamation. Reconstruction alla. Reconstruction alla. Only one company is existing company. That company only will go into liquidation. The same owners will float a new company. So which means anga vandu there cannot be more than two companies. In case of? But in case of amalgamation and? There can be 10 companies together also. Out of 10 companies, 9 companies goes into liquidation. One company takes over all the 9 companies. Absorption. All 10 companies liquidated. New company formed. Amalgamation. Understood. So any number of companies can be involved in amalgamation and absorption. Whatever be the number of companies, they will be called as purchasing company and selling company. That's all. Only two categories of company we have. Correct, Appa? Which means we are going to learn accounting in the books of in relation to amalgamation and absorption. That's all. Everybody. So let us slowly fix our accounting objective, learning objective. We are going to learn accounting in the books of and accounting in the books of. So conceptually, these three are different or same? Conceptually, they are different. For accounting purpose, they are same. Understood? So we have three different concepts involved here: amalgamation, absorption, and. But for accounting purpose, they all these three are. We have two types of company. Whether the problem, the moment you read the problem, you classify the company into two only. You need not analyze it. Though I, for knowledge sake, I classified amalgamation, absorption, and. By reading a problem, I need not classify the problem as amalgamation or absorption. I need to know which company is closing, which company is going to operate. Understood? Which company is going to continue. So the moment the company is liquidated, it is called selling company. Which company is going to be continued is called purchasing company. Everybody, there can be any number of selling company. There can be. But generally there will be only one purchasing company. Understood? Selling companies can be any numbers, but purchasing company only will be one in number. Shall we proceed? Please respond. So this is the basic introduction about amalgamation, absorption, and first of all, why is that two companies should go into amalgamation or absorption? Why should they combine together? Two existing company suddenly joins together. How? Why? To compete with a bigger company, okay. What is the need for amalgamation absorption? Expand its operation. To be specific, I will put it this way. It is increasing market share. Increasing market share. Understood? There are two types of growth possible in a business. One is called organic growth. Inorganic growth. The organic growth is that the company through its operation growing at a higher level. Inorganic growth means a company grows by acquisitions. The company grows by? See, the Lakshmi Mittal in steel industry, initially he was growing only by organic means. He was focusing on his own operations. There is a stage comes that you cannot grow beyond a particular limit by simply you growing. So you will acquire. Whenever there is a steel company coming for, say, the first person to bid will be the Mittal. Are you following? So increasing what? Market share. Are you following? Increasing the market share. It could be for eliminating competition. Not necessary, maybe fighting with some other big company. That could be one reason. Or eliminating competition. Understood? So we keep on compete and keep on cutting down price. They bring out an offer, we bring out an offer, we cut price, they cut price. Both of us are losing in that regard. Correct? Then there will be some intermediaries or they themselves will come forward. Why don't we operate jointly? Understood? So thereby they may combine together to eliminate what? Competition. To create a monopoly situation, they may combine into a single entity. So that way, there will be lot of objectives for amalgamation. Anyway, these things are not going to be tested for knowledge discussion. Introduction we are discussing. Correct? So thereby, amalgamation, absorption are done to increase the market share, to eliminate the competition. Understood? To make more profit, to get the synergy benefits. To get the? Synergy benefit. synthesis of energy. Adana sir, synthesis of energy. When I was taking for CA Foundation some long number of years, organization and then management, what is the need for organization? So why people joins together to form an organization? Why such organization then joined with other organization? Like that when we are discussing, that time only we discuss the concept of synergy, synthesis of energy. You should tell, there will be two popular statements, then immediately you should not interpret in any other way. What one man cannot do, two men can do. I'm following this. Please understand. What one man cannot do, two men can do. When there is inabilities, then together they can perform and do business. What one man can do, two men can do better. These are all two popular management statements, but don't interpret in any other way. Don't make it so dirty. So these are all, this is how the basic need for formation of organization or combining of organizations. Respond.
Yes, sir.
That olden day story only into management thoughts only. A person who was handicapped and another person who was blind. Both can't make their life individually. Person can't see, will fall in so many places. A person can see, but he can't move. Without moving, no life also. Are you following this? So individually for them, no life. If these two person comes together, the person who is blind but who is healthy otherwise, respond, can carry the person who is handicapped, and that handicapped person is not blind, he can see, so he can show the way. And this way, what one man cannot do, two men can do, and what one man can do, two men can do better. This is called synergy benefits. Individually, when they could not have a life, together, old grandma stories, understood? Now please listen. I used to explain in a modern way, in a mathematical way, you should not feel over emotional. No, you should not feel. Mathematically, I used to tell, CBD level, A limited, B limited, two companies. Respond, Pa. They want to multiply their efficiency and make it very big. Everybody, when they multiply their efficiency, A, by multiplying their efficiency on its own, will get a result of A squared to the economy. B, by multiplying its efficiency on its own individually, will get an efficiency of or result of, economic result of, and total result to the economy is A squared and B squared. Correct? Suppose A and B first joined together, respond, and now they go for multiplying their efficiency together, it will result in 2 A squared, B squared, 2AB. Synergy. Anyway, now let us go seriously into the topic. Friends, please stop talking. So the lighter side of amalgamation absorption over. Now let us move into the serious topic of amalgamation and absorption. Shall we proceed, Pa? So we find that amalgamation, absorption, reconstruction, conceptually they are different. They are totally different. But for accounting purpose, they are same. we classify the companies involved into two only, selling company and purchasing company. For accounting standard, we call them as transferor companies, transferee companies.